Bonjour tout le monde. It is a real pleasure to welcome President von der Leyen to Canada. Ursula, thank you so much for being here. No matter where we are, NATO meetings, Canada-EU summit, Brussels, G7 leaderships, I've always been able to count on your insights, your friendship, and your steadfast values. Just ahead of International Women's Day tomorrow, I'm struck by the fact that we're here not only with the President of the European Union, but also with our Deputy Prime Minister, our Minister of Defence, and our Minister of Foreign Affairs, who all happen to be strong women leaders. That is always a pleasure to see. Every day, their expertise and dedication makes the future brighter for people on both sides of the Atlantic. Les liens qui unissent le Canada et l'Europe sont étroits et notre solidarité continue de se resserrer. Aujourd'hui, on renforce encore davantage notre partenariat et on commence par le soutien qu'on offre ensemble à l'Ukraine. We're here at Canadian Forces Base Kingston to meet and thank the women and men supporting operations in Europe. This includes personnel involved in training Ukrainian security forces, Canadians in uniform who have been deployed in Poland to support Ukrainian refugees, and in Latvia to support NATO. There can be no doubt, just as the resolve of our brave women and men in uniform is unwavering, so too is the bond between Canada and Europe. Already, Canada has provided military support to Ukraine and put in place sanctions and punitive economic measures against the Russian regime. Together, President von der Leyen and I also co-hosted an international pledging event for Ukrainians who've been forced from their homes, many of whom have become refugees. For as long as it takes, we will stand shoulder to shoulder together with our European partners for Ukraine. Today, I can announce that we are extending our engineering training as part of Operation Unifier until at least the fall, and deploying CAF medical trainers to help Ukrainian forces with combat medical skills. We're also investing $3 million for demining in Ukraine and working with the EU to deliver energy equipment to Ukraine for their power grid. Je suis heureux de vous annoncer qu'on prolonge la formation de sapeurs de combat dans le cadre de l'opération unifiée jusqu'en octobre 2023 au moins. On va également déployer des formateurs médicaux des forces armées canadiennes pour aider les forces ukrainiennes à acquérir des compétences en médecine de combat. De plus, l'Union européenne a accordé au Canada le statut de pays partenaire dans le cadre de son régime de contrôle des exportations et de sanctions contre la Russie. Ça va nous aider à renforcer notre coopération en matière d'application des sanctions. Comme je l'ai dit à la présidente von der Leyen, le Canada va rester solidaire de la population de l'Ukraine aussi longtemps qu'il le faudra. Today, the President and I also talked about another shared priority, growing strong and resilient economies and creating jobs on both sides of the Atlantic. For over 6 years now, CETA has helped our businesses work together to create growth and opportunities. Later this afternoon, we'll be visiting a Canadian company that recycles lithium-ion batteries for clean tech like electric vehicles. Lycicle is not only creating jobs and building up our critical mineral supply in Canada, they're opening plants in Europe too, so they can do the same there. Whether it's ways that Canada is leading, or ways the EU is leading, or ways in which we're leading together. This partnership means good jobs for our workers and resources that the world needs. So today, we're strengthening this partnership even further. Pendant la visite du chancelier Scholz l'été dernier, on a pris l'engagement de procéder aux premières exportations d'hydrogène vers l'Allemagne d'ici 2025. Aujourd'hui, on annonce le passage à une nouvelle étape avec un plan d'action amélioré sur l'hydrogène entre le Canada et l'Union européenne. The new Canada-EU Enhanced Action Plan on Hydrogen will mobilize investment, support businesses, share expertise, and get clean Canadian hydrogen to Europe. Fundamentally, it's about good middle-class jobs, economic growth, and clean energy. This is on top of work together on protecting nature and fighting climate change to deliver a strong future for our kids and grandkids. There is so much that Canada and Europe share: a commitment to the people of Ukraine, to defending democracy and international law, and to protecting human rights. Shared values like gender equality, and a commitment to growing the middle class and making sure people have good careers they can be proud of and build their families and communities around. And a belief that we can and will build a strong, healthy future for generations to come. Le Canada et l'Europe sont des amis, des alliés et des partenaires commerciaux. En renforçant nos liens, on bâtit un avenir plus fort et plus prometteur pour tous nos citoyens. Ursula, encore une fois, c'est un grand plaisir de t'avoir ici avec nous aujourd'hui.